Before Sauron became the Dark Lord of Middle-earth, he was a mere servant of the first Dark Lord, Morgoth. Yet Morgoth and Sauron weren't exactly alike, and when Morgoth was brought to ruin at the end of the First Age, Sauron cut himself loose and forged his own path, and by the Third Age, he was pronouncing himself as a god. So in this video, I want to talk about the relationship between Sauron and Morgoth, and whether Sauron would have eventually betrayed his master. If you're familiar with Morgoth and Sauron, and if you've watched the videos on my channel, you should be, then you would know that despite both being Dark Lords, Morgoth and Sauron were quite different in their motivations and how they operated. To put it simply, Morgoth was about destruction, angry at the fact that he could not create true life and did not have the mandate to rule the world and everything in it. Morgoth simply resolved to destroy everything. In Morgoth's case, the mere existence of elves and men both offended him and frightened him, and he had no use for them, hence his indiscriminate wars against them in the First Age. On the other hand, Sauron was about order and control. He hated chaos and confusion. In the same sense as Morgoth, he wanted to rule the world. But unlike Morgoth, the existence of other beings and other powers with free will did not anger him. He could understand and tolerate other beings as long as he was the one who would be able to order them around. In the case of elves and men, Sauron attempted to use them as servants first, and would then resort to destruction if they rejected his dominion. So it seems kind of odd that Sauron would serve Morgoth, right? One wants to destroy everything, the other wants perfect order and hates wasteful friction. Realistically, these two should be at complete odds with each other. But there was mutual benefit. Morgoth gained a powerful servant in Sauron, and under Morgoth, Sauron could do what he wanted. He could have his own playthings and his own little playground without having to deal with the red tape and watchful eyes of the Valar. It's also worth mentioning that when Sauron first joined Morgoth, Morgoth had not reached the level of nihilistic madness that he would reach later on. He hadn't reached the point where he desired to destroy everything. Still, if you didn't know any better, you might suspect that Sauron was simply using Morgoth until he could eventually replace him. After all, Sauron is a deceiver, and is even described as more cunning and wise than Morgoth. And as we saw in the Third Age, any residual loyalty to Morgoth had seemingly evaporated as Sauron started referring to himself as a god king. And as the First Age progressed, Morgoth gradually weakened himself by pouring his power into Ardor itself. Tolkien even tells us that on an individual level, Sauron was greater in the Second Age than Morgoth was at the end of the First Age. It all seems too perfect for Sauron to stab him in the back. And for his part, from what we do know about Sauron in the First Age, there's no indication that he was planning on betraying Morgoth. In fact, Sauron's loyalty to Morgoth seems to have been completely legitimate despite their differences. Sauron is described as adoring Morgoth in the beginning and being a true believer in his ultimate triumph. And while Sauron would eventually reach a point where he would acknowledge no power other than himself, at this time, it's said that he still had the ability to admire and admit that there were beings more powerful than himself, and to not work for his own supremacy. But perhaps Sauron never betrayed Morgoth because Morgoth never reached the stage in his plans, if you could call them that, that would have forced Sauron's hand. That's right, even if Sauron wasn't planning on betraying Morgoth, it's possible that he wouldn't have had a choice in the future. As Tolkien explains, Morgoth's thirst for destruction didn't end at elves and men. He wished to destroy everything, even the impossible, such as spirits or matter itself. It's said that if he had achieved victory over all of his enemies, he wouldn't have stopped his destructive spree, and in his madness would have turned on his own creatures, such as orcs. After he had run out of servants to destroy, then he would have raged endlessly across Ardor until it was reduced to a barren, formless wasteland. But he didn't have the capability to destroy creation itself, thus all of his efforts would be for naught, and he would never truly be the victor. So if Morgoth started turning on his own servants, his own creatures, one must wonder what Sauron would have done then. In Tolkien's own words, Sauron hated confusion and wasteful friction, and what is more wasteful and confusing than wanton destruction? When Morgoth was attacking elves and men, at least he had justification. They were his enemies, and in the case of the Noldor, they had pursued him to take revenge. But if Morgoth started randomly destroying his own servants, it doesn't serve any purpose. In fact, it's robbing Sauron of his own agency. Without enemies, Sauron would have the perfect conditions to order things to his liking. But how can he create his perfect order if Morgoth starts undoing it all for no reason, other than the fact that he's insane? And you have to keep in mind, would Sauron himself be safe from Morgoth? Tolkien says that Morgoth would have started destroying his own creatures, which Sauron wouldn't exactly classify as. But in saying that, Sauron was still a powerful being with independent thoughts and will, and as I said earlier, Morgoth absolutely hated this very idea. So it's very much possible that after Morgoth turned on his orcs and wargs and trolls or whatever, he would have turned on those closer to his equal, Maia such as Sauron or the Balrogs, and if it came to that point, surely then Sauron would have turned on Morgoth, because Morgoth turned on him first. So would Sauron have turned on Morgoth? Most likely, yes, but not because he was always planning on betraying Morgoth, but because in Morgoth's nihilistic madness, he would have betrayed Sauron. So the question instead becomes, could Sauron betray Morgoth? As in, could he successfully overthrow and do away with his old master? Well, it depends on the circumstances. As stated earlier, by the end of the First Age, Morgoth had weakened so dramatically that he was weaker than Sauron was during the Second Age. A perfect comparison is their final stands. At the end of the War of Wrath, Morgoth flees to the deepest dungeon of Angband and begs for mercy as he is dragged away. In contrast, at the end of the War of the Last Alliance, Sauron sallies forth in person and seeks out the two enemy leaders to fight them himself. This gives us the idea that if Sauron wanted to personally destroy his former master in a duel, he probably could have done it. Probably because Morgoth would have been trying to run away, and that would be difficult considering he had a permanent limp at this point, thanks Fingolfin. But Morgoth's strength was in his servants and in the very evil will that he had poured into the world itself. At this stage of the game, provided he hadn't destroyed them all, he could turn his servants on Sauron, and in that case, you'd have to imagine that Sauron wouldn't stand a chance, especially if the Balrogs were still around. Sauron is cunning, so maybe he could convince some to rebel with him, but it's also worth mentioning that Morgoth's control over his lesser servants seemed to be absolute, and not even Sauron ever wielded that much control. It's an interesting thought exercise, but I do want to point out that, even if it ever came to this, there still isn't much good that could come from it. Morgoth only would have reached this point after all of his enemies had been destroyed. I'm not sure if that's just in Middle-earth or whether it also included the Valar and Valinor. If he wins, he just continues to reduce Arda to rubble. But even if Sauron replaces him, it isn't really a win. Sauron gets to rule over Ashes, and if there's anything left, he can begin to rebuild. But that's just as scary, because Sauron has spent even longer with Morgoth this time. He's descended further into evil even faster than before, and if he gets to rebuild everything from scratch, he would create a truly awful and terrifying world. I guess if there's one good thing to take away from this, it once again comes from Feyerdahn's quote, "Oft evil will shall evil mar." It points out the unsustainability of evil, and how it will inevitably damage or destroy itself, how Grima turns on Saruman, how Saruman betrays Sauron, how the One Ring destroys itself. In the case of Morgoth and Sauron, the path that Morgoth was taking, his insane desires, would eventually lead to a showdown between the two of them, and only one of them would survive. For evil, there is no happily ever after. Well, actually sometimes there is, but for the sake of a nice end quote, try not to think about it too hard. Thank you for watching, I hope you enjoyed it, or at least found it interesting. I should have named this video, Morgoth vs. Sauron, Who Would Win, for that awesome clickbait. But I think doing such a shameful thing would take 10 years from my life expectancy, which means I would probably retroactively die 5 years ago, meaning this YouTube channel would never exist, which would be a good thing in the end because it means Morgoth vs. Sauron, Who Would Win, would also never exist. Time travel is stupid, I'm so grateful that's one thing Tolkien never messed with. Cheers, farewell, and remember, Belgium was a mistake.